Hi, thank you for taking my call.
Yes.
You're most welcome.
Tim, my question is related to the people, some of the people in Genesis that are recorded as living, you know, 700, 800, right, 900 years old, like Methuselah, sure, and some of the others.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd like to get your take on if that is, if you personally take that literally, or if it's more of, sure, of figuratively.
Yes, and I personally take that figuratively. You can, as a Catholic, believe that to be literal. I take it to be figurative. In fact, the church has been moving for decades away from a literal sort of literalistic approach to the first 11 chapters of Genesis. As you know, Pope Pius XII in Divino Afflante Spiritu, which is a brilliant encyclical letter on sacred scripture, Pope Pius XII says as much, that those chapters use figurative language. You also have the Catechism of the Catholic Church in paragraph 337 that also talks about those chapters using figurative language. So yeah, I take it as figurative. There's some great commentaries on this. For example, we have one here that we use in the office that was published back, I believe, in the 1950s, called A Catholic Commentary on, mm-hmm, Sacred Scripture. And it's outstanding. And it actually gives you the differing opinions on this.
It's post-Divino, yes, as well.
That's right. It's post-Divino of, yeah. So it's excellent. You do get a sense of, yes, yeah, some of the ancients took it more literally, absolutely, even fathers and doctors of the church, but we've certainly grown in our understanding of sacred scripture over the centuries. So, you know, it's not a matter of, oh, it used to be dogma or anything like that. No, this was always a matter of theological opinion.
Well, how's that, Josh? Go ahead.
That's great. And the Catholic commentary, will it kind of explain, okay, well, if it's figuratively, does it go in maybe to the literary style or why they may,
exactly,
use, mm-hmm, it does comment on those things?
Exactly.
Okay.
In fact, one thing you'll find there is, and by the way, it's published by Thomas Nelson and Sons. It's excellent. And I understand it is being reprinted now, because I got something in the mail.
Two words, about time.
Yeah, about time. But at any rate, yes, it even shows how, as you know, some of the contemporary pagan literature had similar sorts of things, where ancients and greats were said to live 1,000 years and, mm-hmm, 2,000 years and that sort of thing. So this, right, was part of the literary genre that was common at that time.
Tim, I've heard it described that the decreasing spans of the lives,
right,
is a kind of a reflection of the spread of sin.
Sin, absolutely.
Very interesting.
That's in that commentary,
oh, well,
too. You've read it. I'll put...
Thank you. I'll polish my halo.
That's right. Sure.
One quick follow-up to,
sure,
that?
Yep.
Does that, okay, if we take it figuratively, does that in any way, or just in general, the genealogies in Genesis,
right,
now I've always assumed that doesn't necessarily cover, you know, everybody in the world, but can we take some of the genealogies and assume that, you know, if it says that this was somebody's father, that maybe that there were generations in between that,
absolutely,
we don't know about?
Sure. So Jesus is called Son of David, right? Obviously,
right,
there were a lot of generations between David and Jesus, 1,000 years worth. So that the son of, and if you do a, in fact, I wrote an article on this years ago, but if you draw a parallel between the genealogies in the Old Testament, you'll find that names are omitted that are in this genealogy. So generations are skipped here and there. And the reason is that there's a literary reason. They wanted to, like in the New Testament, they, mm-hmm, want to zero it down to a multiple of 7 or a multiple of 14, because these are numbers of perfection to show, you know, God's favor. These are God's people. This is God's genealogy and that sort of thing. So they weren't interested in giving a strict historical chronology so much as depicting this as the glorious genealogy of the people of, mm-hmm, God.
Josh, okay, how long have you been listening to the show?
Oh, a good 4 years at least, probably.
Great.
I love this show. I listen to it, especially Tuesdays and Thursdays, but you guys always have great topics too. But I listen to it all the time. So
great. Well, keep it up, Josh.
All right.
Okay, thanks for your call, buddy.
Yeah.
Yes.
Tim, so Sorry, one last question. What was the name of that article you wrote?
Ah, the name of the article. Tell you what I could do, leave your email address, and I'll see if I can drum it up for you.
Okay.
Okay, Josh? That'd be awesome. Yeah, just stay on hold with Diana. All right. Thanks for the call, Josh. Okay. God bless.